I remember when I was applying to medical school and the interviewer asked me, I want to investigate the color yellow in butterfly wings. Would I fund it? And I said, well, I don't see the application of that, so I probably wouldn't have funded it. And he said, well, you know, studying the color yellow in butterfly wings gave us one of the leading cancer and autoimmune therapeutics.
You have to be curious. 40 years ago, people who cared about coronavirus, you know, and how good that those people went on and investigated. You don't know, you set it out what to investigate.
So when I came to Penn, I was interested in making vaccines using dendritic cells that I had studied. And that's when I met Katie over a photocopy machine.
And it was 1998 when he arrived to Penn. And he mentioned that he was coming from Anthony Fauci's laboratory. Didn't ring a bell. This was a long time ago, and Anthony Fauci was not in the television set. Messenger RNA was discovered in 1961. People usually did not see that this RNA can be useful for anything. So I was insisting and persisting because every time we could see improvement.
Katie came to me with RNA. I came to her with the immune system, and it was really like chocolate and peanut butter coming together and making a Reese's cup. And it formed an enormous collaboration.
You will see our personality is very different because I am very bubbling and he's quiet and considerate.
We have completely opposite personalities. Each of us taught each other what they knew. And I think that was what was critical. DNA represents our genetic code. Every single protein, every single sequence that makes our bodies work. RNA is the intermediate. So in order for a cell to make a protein, an RNA makes a copy of a protein in the DNA. It's essentially taking one page out of a journal, photocopying it, and then using it for something.
And he realized that the mRNA is actually inducing inflammatory molecules. And I was worried about that I might would make more harm.
Every week, every month, we would have new results that just surprised us, that we couldn't explain, we didn't understand. And then we spent years figuring out how RNA activates a dendritic cell. And that finally led us to figure out how to make the RNA non-inflammatory. And that's how we developed nucleoside-modified mRNA. It's now being used in the first two approved COVID-19 vaccines.
Drew predicted that we will be invited to give talks and that, and it did not happen. Sometimes, you know, they don't want to change and use something, a different method.
The research that Katie and I did all along was considered superfluous. People just had little to no interest in it. We didn't give up. We saw the potential of it. We saw that it had enormous future impact, and we were luckily right.
Eventually, other scientists did and tried it, and they were successful, and then their publication had drew attention to our publication.
That's life. I mean, you never know where science is going to take you. You never know, is this experiment going to work? You have to have confidence that what you're studying is important, that it has the potential to be critically important, and then you have to persevere and you have to stick with it.